No, thinking about it, I think Beetlejuice should get a sequel.
Yeah, Beetlejuice is pretty good.
Oh, but with Michael Keaton again?
Yeah, you have to have the original actor.
Yeah, yeah, it can't be Beetlejuice without Beetlejuice.
He has fucking, and he can do it now without the makeup. He looks that bad.
He still needs the white and black face.
Of course, you know, you have to make the attire fit, you know, more new age.
Joel, what's your topic?
All right, well, I don't necessarily have a movie as of now, but I'll let y'all start off, I guess. But I want to, like, if there was any movie that doesn't have a sequel, that would deserve a sequel, which movie would it be? A movie that, you know, deserves...
A movie that deserves a sequel.
That just never got it. Or maybe got a sequel.
But didn't deserve it.
I can name plenty of those.
Yeah.
Maybe one of each. I don't know. I just thought of that right now.
I mean, the when you asked that, the only a shitty ass movie came to mind: Green Lantern.
That does not that deserve a sequel. No,
it deserves a reboot. Yeah, but
that's not the Ryan Reynolds. The entire movie was bad.
Well, Ryan Reynolds is good in that movie. Let's get that.
He did the best that he could.
Let's get that shit straight. Ryan Reynolds was not the problem. The script, the direction, everything
Ryan
else.
Ryan Reynolds' abs were not the problem. Okay. Want to say,
Ryan Reynolds' abs were the best. His abs can act way better than I could. I can think of a
movie, A Bug's Life.
A Bug's Life 2?
A Bug's Life 2.
That really?
It ended with... How did it end?
It ended with the happily ever after. Like they, he got little butterfly wings, and he killed the grasshoppers.
Or grasshopper that was the main bad guy.
But didn't they go back to being in the circus all the time?
Yeah.
All the bugs.
Yeah, and they were traveling. And I think, did the ant stay? The main bug?
Yeah, he stayed. He told to kiss the princess and whatnot. Mm,
yeah. No, because then, I don't know, that sequel would kind of be like Shrek 2 in the way like...
But Shrek 2 wasn't a bad sequel.
Shrek 2 was a bad sequel.
It was way better than Shrek. Shrek 2 was way better than Shrek.
No, that is blasphemy.
No,
a sequel could never be good as the original.
Sam Raimi's Spider-Man 2 was better than Spider-Man 1.
I think RoboCop 2 was way better than RoboCop.
Empire Strikes Back was better than Star Wars.
That's different. That's Star Wars.
A little bit better. RoboCop 2 was better than RoboCop 1.
X2 was better than X-Men 1.
RoboCop 3.
The Dark Knight better than Batman Begins.
No.
Yeah, it was so bad.
The Dark Knight was better than Batman Begins. Get the fuck out. I thought we were friends.
I should have took my coworker's advice. Yes. Get the fuck out of here.
That goes to show you never really know someone.
Like the only movie that came close was Terminator. Movies.
Terminator 2.
Well, Judgment Day was the perfect Terminator movie.
No.
It was pretty badass.
It was only badass because of the CGI, the special effects.
But the story, though,
the story came from Terminator 1.
Well, in that case, Genesis should be just as good, if not
better. I want to see Genesis.
Apparently, it's like it's good. Is what I've heard, but I still don't trust that. No, Genesis.
Genesis.
Okay. But I don't trust that.
Call it Genesis.
Yeah. This is all the. I'm just so sick of one-liners at this point.
Whoa. Then you must never see another Vin Diesel movie ever again.
Thank you.
Oh my God! You know, and all the Fast and the Furious movie sequels, with the exception of 2, were better than Fast and the Furious 1.
No,
they all sucked.
Get the fuck out!
Seriously, they all fucking sucked, man.
You know what was my favorite one?
I have to agree. The last one.
Come on, they all sucked.
Family.
You can cut out all the acting and still have essentially what you want to see.
What's his name? Brian Walker? What was his name?
Paul Walker. You just bring in...
That's my favorite one was the last one, just because he died.
This is what happened. I mean, this is what you do.
That's what we said in spoilers.
Yeah. This is what happens. You bring in a former professional wrestler.
I crash horribly, I call it pulling a Paul Walker.
Oh my God.
Not even joking. It's been happening since he died. And I need to quit that because I'll go to hell.
You know, there's sometimes in Grand Theft Auto 4 where you just like fall off a cliff and you just land the wrong way. Your car just explodes, no matter how much you upgrade your armor and everything. Like, yeah. You just hit it wrong and...
Well, I realized in, like, at least San Andreas, when I would skydive from as high as you can possibly go in the jet before it stalls, mm-hmm. I might get the fuck out. And I'm just falling. If you aim for, like, a puddle and, like, this little bitty lake pond in the middle of the city in the park, and it's, like, 4 feet deep...
You'll
survive. I swear to you, you'll survive. I don't know why, but it happens. But yeah, Grand Theft Auto 5 is pretty good. I mean, you know, all I do is kill police officers, but...
David, I do things other than kill police officers. Could you do me a favor? Give me a water, please.
What?
Could you do me a favor? Give me a
water. You know what you told us? It's right there.
Grab me one too, Dave.
We've been talking for like an hour.
Yeah.
We have been talking for an hour.
It's good times, though. Good times.
We were talking about movies that need a sequel.
Yeah.
I got one. Inception needs a sequel.
Inception could be. Oh. Ooh, Equilibrium.
I just thought of a better one.
Equilibrium.
Equilibrium.
David, Joel wants one, please.
What? Oh, water? Yeah. Oh, I thought you were...
Wait, which one's that?
Your microphone.
Equilibrium. Equilibrium was a Christian Bale movie where he's like, dude, they're doing gung fu and everything.
Is that from like was that early
2000s? Early 2000s, like 2002.
Okay, right. Okay. Wait, what? You have a problem with like gung fu? Gung fu?
Kung fu.
Gung fu is what I'm calling it. Gung kata. Okay. They made that up for the movie, right? They invented that for the movie?
It holds some weight, man. There's some shit you get. Oh, God, it was such a good movie.
The circle.
It was such a good movie. It was just so good. But, so good. So
what would the sequel be about, though? It's like they took down that government.
They took down a government, but you have to reestablish order. Because no matter what you are, you're not an anarchist, are you?
Oh, okay.
I just quoted another movie.
I don't know. The Incredibles is going to finally
Hunger Games?
Sequel. No, it was like Ultraviolet. Uh-huh. No, the other one.
I'm so sick of it. I hate the Hunger Games.
Whoa. Get the fuck out.
How dare you, like...
I like Jennifer Lawrence.
Diss on Katniss, you know.
A trilogy based on books aimed at teenagers.
I sometimes start thinking Jennifer Lawrence is a good actress, and then I see The Hunger Games, and I'm like, she's fucking terrible.
She was good in that psychotic...
Silver Linings.
That's what I was going to say, that psychotic one.
Chick from Twilight?
Kirsten Stewart?
Okay, that bitch. What movie did she star in with the guy from Thor?
Snow White and the Huntsman.
Okay. Oh God.
Okay, it was.
That's gonna get a sequel,
isn't
it?
You have to YouTube the scene if you watch this video.
Without her, though.
Where she goes from talking and acting, and he's acting, and they're acting next to each other. It's so bad. She sucks so bad, and he's actually a good actor. Like, he pulls it off. He sells it, and then it goes back to her. And you're like, oh. you tanked that whole performance just then with what you just said.
That's why I don't want to watch that movie.
Snow White and the Huntsman is going to get a sequel without Snow White. It's going to be called The Huntsman.
I think the beginnings.
There's already one called The Huntsman.
What?
Yeah, with Kevin Bacon.
I don't remember seeing that movie.
It was a great movie. It's about a pedophile.
It's a great movie. You totally check it out.
It is about a pedophile, but it is a great movie. It's one of those, I don't know, it's a drama, but inner, like, thinking, and it's, you know, there's these weird scenes.
You know, thinking about it, I think Beetlejuice should get a sequel.
Yeah, Beetlejuice is pretty good.
But with Michael Keaton again?
Yeah, you have to have the original actor.
Yeah, it can't be Beetlejuice without Beetlejuice.
He has fucking, and he can do it now without the makeup. He looks that bad.
He still needs the white and black face.
Of course, you know, you have to make the attire fit, you know, more new age, because that's who Beetlejuice would be. But
okay,
he looks fucking dead.
Was there an Armageddon 2?
No, but no? Should there be an Armageddon 2?
Armageddon 2.
Well, I mean, there was Deep Impact.
It was Deep Impact first, then Armageddon, wasn't it?
I don't remember which one came first.
No, but they came out in the same year.
The same year.
I know that.
Sounds like a fucking porno. Deep Impact.
It's about an
Assmageddon.
But in Deep Impact. Well, Morgan Freeman was the president. Okay.
Morgan Freeman. You know, was president?
And the asteroid actually like hit the Earth and shit got
half of it.
Part of
half
it.
Of
but
it.
Like a third of it, apparently.
You know.
And then the movie called Post Impact.
You know, I noticed that in Hollywood, whenever the president's black.
Shit goes wrong.
Yeah, shit goes wrong.
Except when Chris Rock is president.
And they make fun of that at Chappelle's Show.
Yeah, that was 2012. President was black.
Would you rather see a Simpsons movie 2 or a Family Guy movie?
Neither.
What?
Neither.
Why?
They should
confine themselves to the TV screen and not...
I love the Simpsons movie. It was a good movie.
I like the Simpsons movie.
It was alright, but it I felt it was that a limited itself.
To what?
To crack shot jokes that weren't really funny.
Because, I mean, you're not going to waste because a lot of good episodes on one movie.
It's like, why pay, no, why I pay think, to go watch it at the movie theater if it's
investment as far as ideas, but I don't think you're going to, you can keep a lot of kids entertained by the quirky humor that you can find in most Simpsons.
You know, that's another thing I hate. Whenever TV shows become movies.
Like Entourage seen? And stuff?
Entourage. I didn't see that.
Have you guys seen that?
I haven't seen it yet, but I want to see it. But I'd rather watch the stuff.
Veronica Mars?
I would rather binge watch the Entourage series before I watch the movie.
What was it, Veronica Mars that got turned into a movie?
Yeah.
Yeah, horrible.
Horrible.
Christian Bale or whatever.
Do you want to see? Tragic. You want to see Hancock 2?
No.
Why?
Because, you know, it was a bad movie. It was stay away good. From each other, blah, blah, blah. Who cares?
Something can change.
I have exes like that, too. I just got to stay away from them. And I can keep my powers.
You're a dick.
Yeah. That's why it's like, oh, my God, she's showing up. I got to go. Because I have to keep people alive. That's why. Yeah. But interesting concept, though, how, like, just being together, you cancel each other out, and you become mortal and die. So it's like a tragic kind of thing.
Romeo and Juliet. Star-crossed lovers.
But then again, he was fucking around with the dude's wife. What's up with that? What is up with that?
Was he?
Yeah, he was all like making out with her. And like, dude, that guy was helping you out because he was a cool guy.
Mm.
All right? And he has a kid. You're a fucking douche.
You know? Oh, okay, yeah. I'm starting to remember the movie now. I remember it now. Hancock's a dick. Yes.
Get it? Hancock's a dick.
Inception.
I'm just wondering how the husband like never figured out that she
figured
had
it out.
I mean, like before, like
I like how we're ignoring you.
Yeah, fuck
no,
you
know Hancock. Yeah. The train. He could have picked the train up, but he didn't. He just
destroyed it. Up. Yeah.
He could have got out of the way. Well, they didn't. They never made a Jumanji sequel, right?
No.
No.
They made TV shows.
They made an animated show.
Okay.
Yeah, they did.
That was supposedly a sequel. I kind of wanted Matthew Broderick. I wanted the Matthew Broderick Godzilla to come back, like that sequel to that, because it left with a cliffhanger. The egg hatched. It was a little.
But you're talking about the worst Godzilla movie of all time.
Oh, Matthew Broderick.
They even throw in the ones that they were so shitty.
You know, it made me mad because it did not throw a fire out of his mouth. That was a very bad Godzilla movie.
I was a little kid and I liked that movie because I was so little. I didn't know.
You know what was better?
I didn't know it was bad.
The animated TV shows that came out of it. That was better than the movie.
And that was so weird. It was like you had a pet
Godzilla.
That's
going on. Because they retconned it and like the Matthew Broderick character was there when the egg hatched and so it like
imprinted
on him.
But how does it understand him?
I don't know.
Telepathic abilities?
He's a dog. He's basically a dog.
He's a good boy. Good boy. Did he shits on your Empire State Building? He's like, bad Godzilla. Bad. Shame on you. But I like the new Godzilla. I like the shit out of him.
That was good.
Yeah, and obviously the physicist, what was his solution?
Let them fight.
Let them fight. No.
Let them fight.
Let them fight.
We should try to stop them before they get to a high densely populated area to avoid casualties. No.
Let them fight.
I like that how it should have ended.
I hated the shit.
How it should have ended. Them fight.
They developed an amazing, passionate, awesome character that you can relate to. You became attached to this character, kill him off, get another protagonist. Like, not even halfway through the movie.
The first act.
And here's the reasoning a lot of people say, oh, but you can't really feasibly understand as to why this old man would be able to deal the shit that this guy can do. I can't believe the shit that guy can do. You're telling me he survived all of that crap?
Bullshit. By passing out.
Okay, yeah, that guy could have done it too, and he was a better actor.
Best actor.
What's his name? Dumbass.
Aaron. Kick-ass.
No, Kick-ass.
Yeah, it was Kick-ass.
Aaron Taylor Johnson. Dumbass.
Yeah. More like
Aaron Taylor Johnson, aka Quicksilver.
Quicksilver, who also gets killed off. Oh, I know. Yeah.
Wait, he gets killed off.
You know, there was a quote. You know,
the
from Batman.
The enhanced Quicksilver.
No, no. There's that quote from Batman. Like, you either die a hero or
you live yourself.
Well, it's not true.
See yourself become the villain.
You die a hero or live long enough to be another hero.
That's so true.
Okay,
because they can recast it as another hero.
Yeah, and they said it was like one of the best foreshadowings in movies. I'm like, not really.
What are you talking about?
Like what he said, like either you die a hero or you live long enough to see yourself become a villain. because that's what happened at the end. Two-Face. And then he ends up having to live as the villain in order to, at the end, become the hero. God damn it, dude. Philosophy of the movie, Batman.
The Dark Knight.
But here's the thing. Did you know that Batman was, in fact, a bad guy?
What?
Yeah. Whole movie. Bad guy.
Oh, you're going off that
angle. The Joker? The Joker's the hero?
Yeah, Joker's the hero, but so was Bane.
I read that article.
Why was Bane the hero? Because he believed in a power that the people were in charge of the city and not corrupt bureaucrats that had a system that you can go to jail without trial.
Anarchy. No, I'm just kidding.
Not anarchy. Justice. Actual justice. Oh, no. Who gives a fuck who you are? You did something bad. We're going to punish you. We, the people.
You know, I'd like to see Liam Neeson return.
In what?
As Bane. As Ra's al Ghul.
Yeah,
he was pretty cool.
He's supposed to be a badass.
In the comics, immortal. Yeah, he is the badass.
Immortal.
He actually brought Robin back from the dead.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Throwing the that magic juice.
Lazarus Pit?
The Fountain of Youth.
The Lazarus Pit.
Yeah, Lazarus Pit.
The Lazarus.
Yeah, the kiddie pool. Yeah.
Remember when we tried to do the Lazarus Project?
That actually worked for a few hours.
What about Forrest Gump 2?
I don't know about Forrest Gump 2. It could happen like with him starting in the 90s, later going through the 2000s, living through 9/11.
It would be about his kid.
Haley Joel Osment.
The kid who's not...
Haley Joel Osment.
Not...
Where is it? He's from...
Not special.
Yeah.
Not special.
And...
But he has a special
has
kid.
Everything
himself.
Going but he has for him
AIDS.
In life, including.
But he has AIDS, though, right?
Why does he have AIDS?
Because
the
Jenny
mom had AIDS.
Oh, Jenny that's what she did.
Jenny died from AIDS.
Yeah.
She did not die from AIDS.
She died from AIDS.
Wait, what makes you think she died from AIDS?
Because she was a fucking hooker.
She was a whore, but she didn't die from AIDS. She's getting really sick. She got sick
from a disease that they don't know about anything about because there was at the time when AIDS was just first becoming a thing and the doctors didn't know what to do with it.
I think she had cancer.
It was AIDS. And not to mention, I'm pretty sure there's a book of it and they were more explicit in the book. The book was actually a little different from the movie.
Who has a phone?
Did
Jenny die from AIDS? Yes. It's on Wiki Answers.
Jenny, I love you, Jenny.
Well, anyways, but look, I said earlier so many times. I said Inception 2. Nobody responded. Inception.
I feel like the whole thing with the what was it? What are the things called?
The little spindle thingy or whatever.
The markers or what?
Whatever
totems.
Totems. Yeah.
Totems.
The totems. It was spinning. I know there could be another movie, but there can't be
a second because they have to leave it at.
They have to leave it open ended.
Yeah,
because we don't know if that's a dream or not.
it's spelled Janae.
Did you mean Black Ox?
Did you mean Black Ox?
All right. And then the last thing I wanted to bring up was Wanted 2. But somehow resurrect Angelina Jolie's character.
Oh my god! No way!
Damn, that's the one with the current.
That was
bullets,
some bullcrap shots. No.
I want to see James McAvoy do it Wanted 2, where he's like a badass and he's an assassin or a superhero or something.
Because
I don't think he's gonna be an assassin. I don't think he gave up with that Brotherhood shit. Fuck that little like quilt thingy or whatever.
Well, that's because they went corrupt. They started
choosing.
Yeah.
They started choosing
or
their targets.
Making
Let's
targets.
Say, I can say that the one of the worst sequels ever made was the most recent Dumb and Dumber.
Oh god! I wanted a Dumb and Dumber 2 so badly, but that was not.
That was
what I
a three.
That's three. Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Well, it was a prequel. It was Dumb and Dumber.
It was so fucking bad.
They both sucked. Dumb and Dumber was really good, but the other two.
What happened to him? He's like he used to make good.
They're
movies.
They're old, man. Jim Carrey doesn't want to make anything
funny. Oh, suck a dick!
What happened?
She died from hepatitis C.
Oh,
what?
Was that from the book or the movie? It's answer. It's not specified in the film, but in the sequel book, Gump and Co., which there apparently is a sequel. The author mentions that Jenny dies from hepatitis C as a former drug addict in the early 70s. Hepatitis C was an unknown disease until
1989. Mm-hmm. I guess that makes sense.
That makes sense.
Could have been. I mean,
but I'm still going to go with AIDS. Yeah.
But that still means the kid has hepatitis. And just to be clear, that kills you really fast. And we don't have a vaccine for it till date. We only have hepatitis A and B.
Mm-hmm.
So C can kill you. And if you throw D in there, which is just a fragment of virus that by itself is harmless, throw that in there with Hep C, you're going to die like in a year.
Doesn't Pamela Anderson have hepatitis?
I'm sure she does. Whore and the tatted up boyfriend.
You should date, what's his face?
Tommy Lee?
Yeah, Tommy Lee.
Yeah, by the way, you can get hepatitis from tattoos, FYI.
And Tommy Lee.
From getting tattooed.
And Tommy Lee. Tommy Lee. And Tommy Lee and Pamela Anderson.
Oh my God. We're going to get sued.
Hey, it's.
But the joke's on you. It's only if it's slander. No
money. His YouTube channel has made like $5 and I haven't gotten a check yet.
According to the film, his
score maybe got to make like 20.
Know, yeah, there's a minimum you have to make in order for Google to send a check out.
His score tested IQ was 75.
Mm. Had to be 80, right?
Huh? He had to be 80 to, not, to, be 80, so to not be considered.
His mom had to fuck the principal.
Yeah. In order to get to be enrolled in the regular class.
That's a good ass mom. Yeah.
She did what she had to do. Like, that's like half mine, man. That's like, I don't even know. Like...
Your boy is special, Mrs. Gump.
That's
all you have.
That's nice. You should do the podcast in that voice. Your boy is special, Mrs. Gump. I understand back in the day.
Oof. Dude, how long have we been podcasting?
I think we have one topic left.
We got one last topic. We have one topic left to go.
Dude, we don't have to do it.
You
gotta
be home, right?
Yeah. What? I don't know. I'm taking my parents to dinner, so it's all whenever. Right.